Again, this short-term training course of the CANCOM is a little bit special compared to other short-term training course, because we invited the country coordinator this time. It means, because like the Malaysia, as you know, the really long-term project, too long, like monitoring of the, from the survival leg, growth leg, and now they would like to introduce by native species. So that kind of experience, I guess, is very important. Usually the project 3 years or 5 years finish. But like this kind of, based on the long-term experience and knowledge, so I guess we can share to other countries. For example, like Malaysia is like extinct mining, but also other countries like Myanmar or Indonesia also, they are small, like after mining, but just we don't care. So it's one of the some degradation or deforestation issues. So based on the, this experience, like first faster growing species, after that introduced the native species is real good. And also, I guess, Dr. An mentioned, like training and education, that is also, again, our objective to enhance the capacity building. So hopefully, based on our, like maybe, even the small project funding, so like the long term, so we can share that to other. Now, the another issue from the Professor Leti Sundarwati regarding the community. So as you may know, the protect or conservation of the forest ecosystem is a key issue with the local community. So maybe Professor Leti Sundarwati introduced to us how they're working together with the local community and the management. Please welcome to Professor Leti Sundarwati.
Thank you, Kato-san. Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. I hope you are still awake because it's already a long day today. So it's also the same with Dr. An's presentation that my presentation based on the research with the Akiko project. This is a long, also a little bit long-term project. Since the ACB asked me about the approach on forest rehabilitation and conservation, so here I present about community participation approach on forest rehabilitation and conservation. Some recent actually from the case at Gunung Walat Educational Forest in Indonesia. In Malaysia, the driver of the forest degradation is Dr. An reminding, but in our case, is the driver is concerned with the social problem. The location of the Gunung Walat Educational Forest here is in the West Java province. This is the West Java island. Here is the Jakarta. So it is not far from Jakarta. It's Bogor. It's where I work here in the university in Bogor. Our forest is around 60 kilometers from Bogor. Here in the Sukabumi district here, Gunung Walat Educational Forest. This is our educational forest actually near to the Gedebak Rawa National Park and Halimun Salam National Park, so, two of the biodiversity spots in Indonesia. The driver of forest degradation in the Gunung Walat it's due to the, as I mentioned, the social problem. The Gunung Walat itself is established since 1973 by Faculty of Forestry, Bogor Agricultural University. It was actually, the former is a barren, and then the student, and this place used by the student for the practice, so the student planted trees in that area and then now become a very nice a very good forest vegetation dominated by Agathis, Agathis laurentifolia, and by pine, Pinus merkusii, the only native pine species in Indonesia. But this very good forest, since economic crisis in Indonesia in 1997 and until 2000, facing a degradation due to illegal cutting and encroachment conducted by local people from surrounding the forest area, who were mostly landless and unemployed due to economic crisis. This is some example of the illegal activities by the local people. This is the forest stand, very good, and then by cutting by the local people. And then also they make some clearing to plant it, usually food crops such as rice, cassava, etc. So, to overcome the problem in the Gunung Walak in 2001, we fortunately received funding from ASEAN Korea Environmental Cooperation Project, because at that time the encroachment in Gunung Walak has been very widely conducted by the local people and reached about 213 families. Covering about 75 hectare forest. As I mentioned, the forest area of Gunung Walak actually is not very big, about only about 350 hectare. So 75 hectare is really a big area for our forest. But since there are so many local people already entered the forest and planted staple food there, so it is for us difficult and even impossible to export them from the forest area. So what we are doing then, we try to establish agroforestry in the Gunung Walak, involving the local people, because it is seem to be the only possible promising solution at the time. And then why conserving the forest and preventing the further degradation of Gunung Walak is very important. So that we implement a participatory project there. This is the importance of the Gunung Walak for the local people, because although the Gunung Walak is very small, but it is surrounded by the very dense population villages. Then the forest becomes sort of fodder for the animal bred by the local people, and also sorts of the energy for cooking, sorts of food, and also the most important is the source of water, not only for the household need, but also for the agriculture. So it's why we have to protect and to prevent further degradation of the forest in Gunung Walak. So what is what have been done in Gunung Walak based on the principle and the methodology as following? For the establishment of agroforestry system, we use participatory approach through involving local people in the establishment of agroforestry system, based on the following principle. The first is that the people living and in and surrounding the forest must and need to be concerned in the developing forestry sector in Indonesia, especially because they are integrated part of the forest ecosystem. Most often deserve justice after being neglected and set aside for a long time. And also they have so much big power which could seriously destructive if being ignored and could be supported if given enough concern. So we choose that we give them enough concern so they will support our program. This is our principle. And the other is that the change on the forestry paradigm from protecting the forest from community to involving community and forest management. Furthermore, that establishment of agroforestry at forest area actually was not a new concept in Indonesia. But what was new in the project is that trees and crops planted at agroforestry system in the Gunung Walat were selected according to the local people preference instead of decided by forest manager. Here is that with Martin Sengon, Resalientes Palcantaria, and already existing Agathis laurantifolia as trees component, and Kapi, Copia robusta, Banana, Asapa, and Cardamom as agriculture crop components. This prepared by the local people because they already know about how to plant this species or this crops. And then the local people were allowed to manage the agroforestry plot for 10 years with possible extension under agreement between farmer and the management of Gunung Walat. And decided we keep training and extension to the farmer on agroforestry management to improve their capability. This is the agroforestry establishment. We established agroforestry in the Gunung Walat in the location where the encroachment occurred. This is the design of agroforestry. We have two design. One is in the forest relatively open and in the forest which already exist some trees. And then in the Gunung Walat agroforestry project is in the south part of Gunung Walat. This is the whole area of Gunung Walat with Agathis in this area. And this is the base camp. And this is all the surrounding by villages. Yeah. And then the agroforestry is in the south part of the Gunung Walat area because the encroacher is come from this side. This is this village is bordered directly with the forest. And besides that, we also conducted intensive treatment of agroforestry to increase the production. Yeah, for example, for the kapi, we conduct intensive treatment such as pruning and also some other treatment conducted by my colleague from the silviculture department. And we also conduct capacity building for the farmer, such as some training on the, how to mix what is organic fertilizer, and also some training on the cultivation of kapi, and also some training on the processing of agroforestry product. Because usually the farmer selling product fresh product, so we would like to increase their income through additional to edit the value of the product through the processing. So we also give the training on the how to process the agroforestry product. And the impact and positive result of that approach is the first is there is increasing on biodiversity. Establishment of agroforestry in the degraded forest area of Gunung Walat has increased the diversity of plant species. For example, Before agroforestry, the trees only three species dominated: tamar, pine, and puspa. Acanthus, Pinus mercosii, and Sima walesii. But after that, we have five three species: tamar, pine, puspa, sengon, and mahogany. And from the agriculture crop, before there is no one agriculture crop, but through agroforestry, we have now cardamom, taro, cassava, cafe, and banana. So through this agroforestry and through community participation approach, the positive impact is the increasing of biodiversity. This is an example of some of the agriculture crop, the banana. And this is the cardamom, this is kafe, this is some product from agroforestry in Gunung Galang. This is the taro, the kafe. Besides that, the positive impact is on secure tenurial system. Securing the tenurial system has been conducted through a longer period of contractual agreement with local people and a better sharing of benefit. A legal contract between local farmer and the manager of Gunung Walat on behalf of the IPB, the university, has been made. And the farmer, as the project participant, are allowed to cultivate the forest according to the plan of agroforestry for about 10 years. And then after that, all the agroforestry department is not very large, only 1.16 hectare, but it is very important for the local people because it could increase their income. Or added to their income. Other positive impact is that people interest and participation, which will become the concern of our project through participatory rural appraisal, regular meeting, the interest of local people, including their preference of one species was discussed. The time, opportunity, cost of the people invited in the meeting, training, extension, as well as in certain forest work was valued because they were mostly very needy people. And participation of the local people in the project was very important to ensure the success of the project. And as I mentioned before, that although the area of agroforestry per family is not very much, but it's still very beneficial for the people because it could increase their household income. The agroforestry has contributed to the cash income of the farmer, and more importantly, the agroforestry has given a certain level of stable food security to the farmer. This is the increasing of income. Cash income, the additional cash income for the household increased from 2002 until 2009 until 20% from the household income. And this is the daily income source, which is until now the farmer still receive. It's through the daily wage from tapping grazing of Agatis and pine. Because before our project, the pine and agatis was not has been not tapped, and then after that we make a tapping activity from the agatis and pine, and then the farmer could get away from this tapping activity around 20,000 until 15,000 per farmer per day. It's around $2 until $5 per day. For the farmer, it is really a big additional income. And besides that, also selling of firewood from agroforestry plot is also become a sort of income because there is increasing of demand on firewood due to the increasing of kerosene price. So as a conclusion, that hire people's role and interest along with secure and tenure and support the success of forest rehabilitation as well as the increase of people with money. Participatory approach in the situation of higher pressure of people demand for agricultural land seem to be the better approach of forest rehabilitation and conservation. Thank you.
Thank you.
So is there any other some question or comment? Okay, thank you, Lenny.
Yes, again, income source in the forest area in Korea also is very important because we try to encourage the people to return to the forest area to manage sustainably or conserve the forest ecosystem, but it still is not easy. So I guess it's the same time that we also Korea had the experience like economic crisis under the IMF control. So that time the many jobless people returned to the forest and the tending pruning campaign. That is one of the good our movement. So hopefully we also share the like NGO movement. So now I would like to invite Professor Josefina Dijon regarding the